Hello students, welcome to EC Engineering. And in this video, I am going to explain you the measurements of energy using energy meter, which is one of the experiment comes under Group A Electrical Engineering in Engineering Practices Lab. Let us see the experiment objective and all one by one. So according to this experiment, we need to calculate the single phase energy meter by direct loading method. These are all the components required for the experiment: voltmeter, ammeter, energy meter, auto transformer, resistive load. See here, for a single phase, voltmeter should be 300 volt MI meter, for ammeter 0 to 10 amps MI meter, and energy meter 10 amps to 30 volt. Auto transformer is in the range from 230 bar 0 bar 270 volt. Resistive load 4 kilowatts 230 volt. And this is a formula required to do the calculations. Power, here power is equal to voltage into current. So direct loading. And we need to draw a graph also. So procedure is given. We'll see from a formula one by one. Power is equal to voltage into current. Not cos phi, simply voltage into current. True value equal to P into time by 1000 into 3600 kilowatt per hour. Kilowatt hour. Measured energy is number of revolutions in an energy meter to the energy meter constant. The percentage of error could be calculated as measured energy minus true energy by true energy into 100. So with this, we'll pass on to the procedure side. As per the procedure, connections are given as per the circuit diagram. Note down the precautions and fuse connections. Take the no load no load values, and reading should be taken for all the loaded conditions, and repeat the experiment as long as the current maximum value of 10 amps. Now take an tabular column where the energy meter constant for this particular experiment 7 for 50, then voltage, current, power, evolutions for 50 seconds, true energy, measured energy, and percentage error should be calculated one by one. Note down the circuit diagram. So in a circuit diagram, we'll see the energy meter, which has M, L, C, V coils. See the connections as per the circuit diagram. Clearly observe the circuit diagram. Supply is given, and given supply is given to the auto transformer via fuses. In auto transformer to two ends, one to ammeter moving iron and another one to voltmeter. Then ammeter is connected to energy meter M. Then energy meter L to load. Load is again connected back to the auto transformer. Then M and C shorted. Then L to load and V to again a neutral point. So with this connections, coming back to the circuit side. In a board, we are taking a single phase supply. Take either of the knobs. R phase is connected to the auto transformer. R phase, take cousin blue red color wire is connected to auto transformer. Here auto transformer three terminals central, take it with an zero minimum position. So set it with a minimum zero position. Phase 2 auto transformer. Then auto transformer neutral is already connected to the neutral. auto transformer neutral connected to the neutral. Then variable end, third end, variable end to the ammeter and a voltmeter. See the blue color wire given as a thin wire connected across an voltmeter. Then one more wire, red color wire, this wire is connected to the ammeter of 10 amps. See here, ammeter of 10 amps. So in a variable end, we have two wires, one wire to ammeter, one wire to voltmeter. Voltmeter, thin wire, then thick red color wire is connected to the ammeter. So voltmeter is connected across neutral and then what? Connected across neutral and then auto transformer. Connected across the auto transformer. 300 volt. Then one more red color wire is connected to ammeter. This thin wire is a blue color wire. Then ammeter. Ammeter's other end is connected to M of the energy meter. M to M of the energy meter, red color wire. Then this M and C short circuited. M and C short circuited. Then L to load. L to load. Then again we have V connection. See, L to load. Here resistive load, phase. Positive red color connected in a red color. Then V to again V to the negative point. Either a negative point or complete the cycle by given to the auto transformer. So negative is shorted here only. Load negative is connected to through auto transformer, through voltmeter to auto transformer. MNC short circuit is already we have seen. MNC short circuit. So while we are moving for an precautions, so all the connectivities were made, then negative connections all closed. We'll check the positions. The switch is in an off position, tripper also in off position. All the resistive loads are in off mode. What auto transformer is in a minimum position, zero position. So this is the right time to start up the experiment. So what is the experiment? Slowly adding and increasing an voltage. We need to observe voltmeter, ammeter and an energy meter readings for various loads. Okay. First initially zero load, then slowly increasing and load, voltage decreases, current increases, energy increases. So load increases, voltage drops a little, current and power consumption increases. How the power consumption increases, that we can see it from a wattmeter's rotation. Now switch on the tripper. Auto transformer slowly varied up to the 230 volt. See here, slowly varied up to 230 volt. Slowly varied, observe in a voltmeter, the pointer deflects up to 230 volt with zero load condition. We are setting up an reading 230 volt. 230 volt. Fine. 230 volt is given. Clearly you have seen 230 volt. Now observe ammeter and an energy meter. Because all the loads are zero, so obviously ammeter reads zero reading and energy meter reads zero reading. And make a note of these things in a tabular column. So in a tabular column, first reading 230 volt. So make a reading, then increase the load and mark down all the readings one by one. Then put a first reading. Your energy meter starts rotating. See here, and red color mark shows its rotation. So whenever the red color comes in contact with the next time, it will take it as one revolution. 1 revolution. So now note down an ammeter reading. It is slightly moves. So a minimum value. What about on voltmeter? Voltage reading drops somewhat. Drops from 230 volt. Drops somewhat. Okay, note down the second reading. Then go with the second reading. Now observe the wattmeter, energy meter readings. So how much 50 counts we are taking. The timer, we set right on timer. Click on and we are counting up to 50 second. How many rotations of an aluminium disc. Timer starts, so slowly observe the timer and an aluminium disc. It's one rotation. Clearly observe up to 50 seconds. How taking an readings. Note down the readings for second. It actually gives you the 2 counts. Then go for an next load. Now the voltmeter, ammeter readings also be noted. Well, slowly we note down the next one. 2. Second load applied. Now check an ammeter. The current increases, voltage drops further. Then go for an energy meter. Make a count. Start a rotation. Whenever it reaches a red color mark initiates, then we can switch on a stopper. So here the count is for 50 seconds. So we counting the rotations. Timer switched on. Timer switched on for 50 seconds. Now note down the counts of an energy meter, aluminium disc revolution. Seconds going on. 10, 15. Goes on. Each red color gives one rotation. We need to check for 50 seconds. So similarly we are watching up to 50 seconds. It comes nearer to 50 seconds. Next one revolution completed in energy meter. It goes with next one. So we stop the stopper. Yeah. Exactly, it makes the counts. How many numbers? 6 numbers. How many numbers? 6 numbers. Okay. So, the rest of the things we need to calculate it using the formula. The formula also given over there. So, the energy meter constant is given here as energy meter. Is a single phase 240 volt 50 hertz. So the energy meter constants given us 750. So in order to calculate the error, power should be calculated. Power formula, everything we know. And draw the graph. Slowly I will explain you. So these are all the readings we have taken from a reading. Voltage, current, power, revolutions for 50 seconds, true energy, measured energy, percentage error. The energy meter constant is 750 given here. Okay. So first find the power. Power P is equal to formula current into voltage. So current into voltage, merely multiplying these two, we will get these readings. Merely by multiplying the things. Then next one, clearly observe, these readings were taken from 50 revolutions seconds. How many rotations are there? Next, true energy. True energy equal to P into time by 3000, means 1000 into 3600, means kilo 1000, whatever 3600. So here 36 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. 5 zeros. Time is the constant time. We have taken it as 50 seconds. So it is applicable for all the readings 50. And this P means power. So for each and every reading, we have different power. So these things are common. 50 divided by 3, 6, 00, 00, 1, 0. 000, 00, 000. These readings are common. And power takes the different readings and make a multiplications and a divisions. Usual method, we get a true value for each and every one. Then measured value. See here, the measured value equal to number of revolutions by energy meter constant. Energy meter constant is 750. Number of revolutions, see here we have found as 0 for first 0 load, 1 load, 2 load, 3 load, it goes on increasing. So I am example, I am taken it as a 4th reading. So 8 by 750, it gives a measured value. Then what is then? Percentage error, measured value minus true value divided by true value into 100. That is what I did here. For a reading number 1, measured value is this one. So measured value, what is the true value here? True value divided by true value into 100, it gives minus 4.5. Then take a graph. While drawing a graph, take amperes current in x-axis. So we have a ranges of currents from ranges of currents from 0 to 5. Reading of error, it's both minus reading and then plus reading. That's why we can split up and scale as minus error and a plus error. So what is the first value? First value current and then error. First value current 0, error 0. Second value 1.3 minus 10. Then 2.4 plus 8.5. See here. 0, 0. 1.3 and minus 10. Similarly, we drawn all the graphs. We can get a graph like this. So while I'm drawing 10 point here, while I am drawing 10 point here, plus 8 point here, through 1.3, it will comes like this. So you can make own corrections. So this is the way we are doing our experiment. So that's it. All the readings were tabulated. After making the things, switch off all the loads and comes the auto transformer comes into the original position 0. Then after make